Hello everyone, in this video we have 1 square and here is 45 degrees, here is 1 unit and this blue shaded area equals P and this green shaded area equals G and the ratio of these two areas is ask. Okay, first step we know that these are 90 degrees because of square and let's call here alpha. This angle must be 90 minus alpha and let's call here theta. This angle must be 90 minus theta, right? Okay. And then notice that alpha plus theta equals 45 degrees. So if we get here alpha degrees like this, and let's connect here, this angle must be 90 minus alpha. And let's call here K point. If here is 1 unit, this length is also 1 unit, and this triangle have same angle and same length, right? That means these two triangles are congruent. PKT triangle. And SET triangle are congruent. Therefore, opposite of 90 degrees must be equal. And if there's an x unit opposite of the alpha must be x unit. And then this angle is 45 degrees and let's call here y unit and I want to represent this side with circle sign. Notice that double line circle and 45 degrees, double line circle and 45 degrees. That means these two triangles are congruent, right? KTF triangle and ETF triangle are congruent according to side angle side. Okay. And then, so we know that if these are congruent triangle, the area of this triangle must be equal. So the area of this triangle equal half of the base and height equal this blue area equal B and this green area equal G. So B plus G. Okay, this is the first equation. And then if we draw the other diagonal of this square, here must be 90 degrees and these four parts must be equal, right? Let's remind you, if you have a square and let's draw the diagonal of this square, this angle must be 90 degrees and these four parts must be equal and these are 45 degrees. Okay, and if this length is equal 1 unit, here must be 1 over root 2, right? Because of isosceles right triangle. So this length must be equal 1 over root 2. And if here is 45 degrees, that means this angle must be theta and likewise, this angle must be alpha. Okay, if it is theta, this angle must be 90 minus theta. And if it is alpha, this angle must be 90 minus alpha. Okay, and then let's call here O point, and this length let's call here A, and this length let's call here B. This triangle and this triangle are similar, right? Because they have same angles. So O and T triangle similar to PFT triangle. According to angle similarity theorem. Okay. Therefore, B, which is opposite of the theta, over Y, which is opposite of the theta, equal 1 over root 2, which is opposite of the 90 minus theta, over 1, which is opposite of the 90 minus theta. Therefore, B equal Y over root 2. Okay, this is the second equation. And then the angles of this triangle and the angles of this triangle are equal. That means these two triangles are similar. So OLT triangle and SET triangle are similar, right? Because they have same angles. According to angle similarity theorem. Okay. And then A, which is opposite of the alpha, over X, which is opposite of the alpha, equal 1 over root 2, which is opposite of the 90 minus alpha, over 1, which is opposite of the 90 minus alpha. So A equal X over root 2. This is the third equation. And then we know that ratio of B over G is S, so this blue shaded area equals half of the base and height, so B equal half time A plus B, height is 1 over root 2, so 1 over 2 times root 2 times A plus B. A plus B equal X plus Y over root 2. So B equal X plus Y over 4, right? Okay, this is the blue shaded area. And then if we plug in this value to the formula, we get the green shaded area, right? Okay. B plus G equal X plus Y over 2. So B equal X plus Y over 4 plus G equal X plus Y over 2. That means G equal X plus Y over 4. So these two values are equal. That means ratio of B over G is going to be 1. Thanks for watching.